How did you come together with M1 to do this new project?
Well, this is, you know, this is a project that has kind of been ongoing. It started out as maybe one or two other projects with Kentia. Kentia and I had worked with Ron Carter. We did some stuff with Ron Carter, and that's, we got together with Mike Clark to do those. And Ayeto Morera, we did some stuff with. And also Ayeto's daughter, Dee, who also appears on this album. Also, Killer Priest was involved in a live project that we were working on also. So a lot of these people that are on this project happen to be, you know, associates or friends of ours from, you know, from already back a few years ago. M1 was somebody who we had always wanted to involve in some of the things that we were doing. We had gotten together with Wise Intelligent, like I said, you know, Killer Priest. We had actually gotten together with Aloe Black to do some stuff. We had gotten together with Chuck, with Chuck D. We had tried to chase Chuck down. He's so busy, you know, but very graciously, you know, he accepted and offered to do something with us. So, you know, M1 was one of those people that we really wanted to use and to work with.
Basically, then you have a lot of musicians lined up or worked with.
There were, yeah, you know, over the years we had run into a lot of people who were interested in collaborating with us, and this is the combination of, I think, some of the best of it. Yeah.
What are your plans after this project? Is there something else that you have planned?
Oh yeah, well I like a lot of different kinds of music, and I have over the years I've gotten. I'm very interested in the manipulation of sound. You know, people used to, when I was younger, people used to call me Mr. Colors, because I always wanted to, you know, there were a bunch of artists that were working with kinds of effects and, you know, and that kind of, like Herbie and George Duke and Joe Zawinul, you know, people like that who were actually kind of working more with the whole idea of color. And painting in montage. I mean, gosh, there are a lot of musicians like that, a lot of synthesists in every discipline who have attempted to do things like that, and it interests me a lot. Now, in the more popular area, or the, you know, maybe the underground, I don't know what you would call it, but there are a lot of interesting artists who work with different palettes and create music that is, you know, it's thought-provoking and it's soul-provoking as well. And I like that kind of stuff. And I know that they work, many of them work with samples and loops. And it's always been interesting to me to see how that might come together. It's not a new thing, but it's just something that I've always been interested in. I've always wanted to know how that might come together with an acoustic piano. Right. Your flute, you know, or any of the instruments that I'm interested in.
You just mentioned George Duke, he just passed.
He just passed as well. Yeah. I know. And that was a big blow to me because he was a huge, I mean, I can't even tell you how much of an inspiration George Duke was to me.
Very interesting man. I interviewed him twice as well. And he was, I was shocked because just suddenly I saw the video, he looked very slim, and I thought, hey, something's wrong here.
Something's wrong. He was battling his illness.
Yeah.
And who knew? I mean, I think, you know, his wife had passed last year.
Exactly.
And I don't know, you know.
Came back to get him.
He was, exactly. And I don't think he regrets.
No.
You know, I know they had been together for a long time. Oh, yeah. Very, very close.
together.